Hello and welcome to the scripting tutorial for Kingdom Come Deliverance. This tutorial requires that you have already properly set up your local database and that you have installed all the necessary tools. For the first exercise, you will only need the CryEngine sandbox editor, but later you will also need Scald, Storm and Swift. The sandbox editor executable is found under Steam Kingdom Come Deliverance folder under bin Win64 release DLL. You also have to create this user.cfg file and fill it with these parameters, with proper values of course. Now let's launch the editor. The editor will take about 20 to maybe 60 seconds to launch depending on the power of your computer. We sped this process up for obvious reasons. Now this is the welcome window for the sandbox editor. Ideally, you should use a 2 or even 3 monitor setup. But in this video, I can only use one screen. If you do, however, possess multiple monitors, I will show you how to take advantage of it. Normally, you would maximize the main window. And then you could use the other tools, like these two, combine them and move them to the other screen. I will try to squeeze as much information into this one screen as possible. For this purpose, I will also set this specific CVAR to value 1, and I will also copy this value into the user CFG file so that for every subsequent startup I don't have to set it up again. What this CVAR does is very simple. When you move the tools window just a bit, it will force the refresh and they will start behaving like a normal window. They will not overlap with the main window and you can minimize them, maximize them at your will. Let's start the actual exercise. We want to create a new level. Let's give it a name. This level will be stored under the levels folder. You can find it under data, levels. We certainly want to use the terrain and we want the level to be small. Now as you can see, a new folder with the name of the level was created under the levels folder. The level creation takes several seconds. And now we will be asked about the quality of the terrain. We don't need anything fancy. An error window might appear, but you can close it. You can look around when you are holding down the right mouse button. You can also use the WSAD keys and scrolling to control the camera. Move up a bit and you will see the flat terrain. Now, using Ctrl-G should start the game mode. However, this doesn't work in a newly created level. To get rid of this error, you only need to save the level and reload it again. And now when I press Ctrl-G, I'm in the game. When I press Shift Escape, the game mode ends. So, the goal of this exercise is to have an NPC, create a new brain for it, and make it play a simple animation. So first we need the NPC. You can find it under rollup bar, entity, AI, NPC. NPC is a male NPC. The other option is NPC female. They are different because they have different skeletons. Just drag and drop it. As you can see, it is now snapping to a sort of a grid. You can change the setting here, and now we have very fine control over the entity's placement. One more detail. If we happen to have an object somewhere in the air, I want to place it back to the ground, we can do this by holding down Ctrl Shift and clicking left mouse button. Next, we want to create a new sublayer called NPC. Now we want to save the level, move the NPC to its new sublayer, and save the level again. You may have noticed in this process that there are these asterisks appearing and disappearing. They indicate any unsaved change. Now I want to rename the NPC entity. As per the instructions, his name should be test_st_NPC1. Now, as you can see, the asterisk reappeared. You can also see it here, so maybe we should save the level again. Now we have the entity named, and we have to give it a soul. So, under View, open View Pane, you have all these tools, and what you need is Warhorse NPC Editor. There, you go to the Properties tab, and you must have the NPC selected. Here, as you can see, you can connect the man to an existing soul, which will make him behave and appear as any predefined male NPC. But we want to create a new soul. Soul data is stored in the database, but pressing this button will not save the data immediately. It will only prepare the operation. This is indicated by missing shared soul name here. So to actually commit the data to the database, you have to either save the level or any layer of the level. Let's do just that. Now if I reselect the NPC, you can see the soul name finally appeared here, which confirms that the data was finally saved into the database. So this soul is now using the NPC test base brain, which is just a default brain which does nothing basically. But we don't want to change the definition of this brain, as it would affect any newly created NPC. We want to create a new brain. For this, we need another tool. It's called Warhorse XGen NPC Editor. It's the other window I already had opened here. Let me just adjust the sizes of these various sub-windows. Now we want to create a new brain, so go to the Brain tab and click Create New button. And give the brain a name. Let's give it the same name as of the NPC entity. Now the brain is created. Now a brain doesn't actually do anything, it's just a data structure, a handle of sort. What can hold any actual executable script is Subbrain, so let's give our brain a new Subbrain. Just click this new button here and let's fill in all these properties. For the name of the subbrain we will use the same and just add _main suffix. NPC brains need the type behavior tree. And we want to specify an XML file which will hold the actual implementation of the subbrain tree. we want to create a new subfolder underscore test and then specify the name of the XML file and let's give it the same name. This subfolder will be created in the AI root folder, which can be found here. For the operation we are doing right now to work, you also need to pay attention to this default XML file. You can find it under data underscore reference folder in the modding package. You need to have it copied here in the AI root folder. The behavior tree type only supports on updates tree, so let's have it checked. And we also want it to be always active as opposed to activated on demand. Always active will just run all the time. Now that we have the brain and its subbrain defined, let's click the save brain here, which will save it to the database and it will also create the XML file we specified. As you can see here, the new subfolder and the XML file we specified have been successfully created. When I reselect the NPC, you can notice that he still has the old brain and subbrain. That's because we haven't changed the brain that is to be used by the soul. So we need to give him the new brain. We have to resave the level to update the soul settings. Now we have to reload the AI script. And when I reselect the NPC again, we should finally see the new subbrain. Now we can finally start scripting this guy's behavior. When you are in the tree editor, you can press spacebar, which will start this search function. You can write in any filter tokens, and the search function will give you a list of nodes that fit the filter criteria. You can navigate through the list with arrows. We want a node called play animation. It is the first search result, so let's just press enter. And then connect the node here. The NPC can now play an animation, but it doesn't know which one specifically. Let's find the animation in the mannequin editor. To see all the male skeleton animations, you have to load the male preview file. There are a lot of animations, so loading will take its time. You may also see some errors, but you can ignore them. Now, we may not know exactly which animation we are looking for, so let's do some searching. We want the NPC to wave his hand, so let's use the word wave. And let's try it in the fragment ID filter. Well, we failed. We got no results. Let's try the same for the tag filter. Now we're getting something. Now we can see that the animation fragment is actually called Greetings Upper Body, and that the full tag name is Wave Small. You can preview the animation by clicking it twice and pressing this play button. The fragment ID name goes into the animation property. And the tag name goes into the tags property. The editor might crash when you try to enter the game mode with the mannequin tool open, so let's close it. Let's now jump in the game and see what he does. And here we see the first problem. The animation is being played over and over again, because as the play animation node succeeds, the whole tree restarts itself, which is its inherent property. We want the animation to be played just once, so let's exit the game mode with Shift Escape and see what we can do.
So we want the play animation to be followed by wait node with time set to -1, which means infinity. In order to execute these nodes one after another, we need a sequence node. A sequence node simply executes its child trees, or child nodes in this case, in sequential manner. So let's resave the tree using either this save function, or when you are in the tree editor, you can simply use Ctrl S. Let's jump back in the game mode and see what happens. And he does exactly what we needed him to do. Congratulations, you've just finished exercise 1. See you next time.